TV for the last time today from Rome, from the site event of G7 Energy Ministerial Meeting. And we are speaking with the president of the organization who organized this meeting just after a very busy time, and also meeting with the Minister of Development of Italy. So Francesco, how was actually the event? Was it so sunny as the weather today in Italy?
I think it was fantastic. It was extremely interesting. There were tons of different stakeholders who came and provided insights about what's happening in the energy sector in Africa. And I think the most relevant point is that everybody agreed that either all these forces work together or nothing is really going to change. And since there were so many forces, different forces saying exactly the same thing, now I have hope that it really is gonna happen.
And how this, you know, let's say, environment that we have G7 Energy Ministerial Meeting, so let's say the biggest economies here in Rome, how did it help to bring attention?
Well, I mean, obviously it's a big, big humongous event. This is just a side event that is trying to bring not just the big seven at the table, but also many other countries all together. So I believe that without the support of the big economies, for emerging economies, it's going to be tougher. But we know that we have the support. So now it's the time to act.
Okay, let's switch now to another topic, because in the past, ENEL Green Power was a windy company. Now you are becoming more and more sunny. So last year, I think you increased solar capacities like over 100%, yeah? So how do you see, you know, this year for ENEL, especially in the solar industry?
So you're not asking me this question anymore as the president of Res4Med, but as the CEO of ENEL Green Power. So the big change, I mean, solar technology is becoming more and more competitive. Obviously, now you can exploit two different natural resources instead of one. So it's wind and the sun. And I think that we will see solar becoming more and more important in the future. I mean, this was the first year that we had more megawatts installed with solar technologies than wind. It's a big signal to the whole market. I think that solar is going to be extremely important in the future. The two technologies are going to survive together, there is no doubt. Mm-hmm. Wind is also becoming more and more competitive. So it's going to be a big race. I think that the two technologies are willing to team up to compete with thermal generation.
So what is your forecast for solar installations done by ENEL in 2017?
In 2017, we are above 1 gigawatt of solar installation. I think that we are getting close to the 4 gigawatts of PV installed by the mid of 2018, if I'm not mistaken. So big numbers, absolutely.
Okay, so today's topic, now we return to the event, was Africa in 2030. So how do you imagine Africa in 2030? Do you think maybe it will be 100% of renewables? And how do you imagine you and ENEL Green Power in 2030, besides the fact that we will be still so young?
I imagine Africa being closer to the rest of the continents in terms of development. Actually, I think that there is a big, humongous opportunity for the African continent to become the first real sustainable continent around the world. I mean, there is opportunity for them to leapfrog technology-wise, mm-hmm. but also to create a real socio-economic environment around the energy sector. So big opportunity, 2030, hopefully that's going to happen. But us, we're going to keep growing. ENEL is probably right now the biggest utility outside of China and around the world, at least in terms of capitalization. I see a big prosper future. I don't see just renewables. I see renewables, I see networks being utilized more and differently. And I see our company, we are investing more and more in digital services.
And we are like a family, yeah? all the clean energy companies.
Absolutely, we are a big family.
Okay, so thank you so much. And now I will leave you to your personal family because they are waiting for you. Thank you so much for the interview. That was Solar PV TV together with Francesco Venturini, CEO of ENEL Green Power, also president of RES for Africa, the organization which brought together this great event here in Rome. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.